Hey guys, it's Julie from Plan to Create, and in my last video I mentioned that I had done a little bit of Black Friday shopping for my planner, and I have three orders that still haven't arrived. So I wanted to share with you my whole order today, but it's impossible because they're not here. So I thought I would kind of break it up and do at least this one and show you the stamps that I ordered that have arrived. And then in the meantime, I have switched up my stamp storage, so I wanted to share that with you, as well as just some of my favorites, because I feel like those are questions that I get asked a lot, like which stamps do you like, companies, etc., etc. So I will share the ones that I purchased for Black Friday, starting with this guy. This is a monthly stamp set. It's called Monthly Matters from Feed Your Craft. And that's just become one of my favorite new stamping go-to companies. I have a whole Feed Your Craft tab here in my little setup. So I'm gonna file this one back, but you'll see me using quite a few of these. I have another one set out that I'm using this month on my daily pages. It's this cute holiday happiness. You guys have seen me use the Bits of Life, I believe. I'll pull that one out real quick too. So just some really, really cute stamps. And let me grab a couple more because I love them. So there's the Monthly Matters. This is another one that I feel like is gonna be really fun to play with in a planner. I haven't like put it to its full extent yet. You can see I've added a few little things, but not really, really put it to use yet. And then this is another one called Date Documented. Obviously, I feel like their company is set up mindfully for scrapbooking and memory keeping, but there's so much crossover. And like this set is really great and fun to use, particularly on daily pages in a planner, or you know, if you really had a blank slate, like bullet journal, and you wanted to set up your week with some dates but didn't want to handwrite everything, wanted to use a stamp set, I feel like this is a really viable option. So those are some of my favorites from Feed Your Craft. Okay, then I only ordered two other new stamps, and one of them is this brand new Numbers Galore. It's so cool, it's so huge, and I love the impact that this can make in a planner. If you guys have seen, I'll try to share a shot of it here, but a lot of my intro pages, I'll have the vellum with the year at a glance, the year on one page, and then behind that, I love to stamp in bold colors the year. So 2020 I've done, 2021. So this one is from the Stamp Market, and I ordered that because, number one, I have had a larger number set in the past. I think it's the Jack number set from Studio Calico, but it's not available, and I'm not sure if they're bringing it back. So I thought I would go ahead and pursue a different one, try it out, and see for you guys, and I think this is going to be a great option. And then the other thing that I ordered, don't laugh at me, you guys, I ordered this set. And if you've been around for a little while, you know that I already have this set, so why would I order it? Well, I lost the number one somewhere, and that's my bad. It's because I get lazy and maybe don't put them back right away, or I don't clean it so it doesn't stay sticky. So my bad, and I loved this number set so much that I went ahead and ordered another one while it was on sale during Black Friday because I know that I will use this. It does have this great January through December long stamp at the bottom there. Hope you guys can see that. So that's really fun too. Like you can put that at the top of your page and then circle the month that you're in. Just some, again, like not made for planners per se, but so much great crossover that I love that when these kinds of things show up in the stamping world. I haven't put this one away yet, so I wanted to show you. I have taken everything out of their packaging, but I wanted to show you all the stamp sets that I've ordered. They all come with this back plastic sheet, and like you're welcome to just continue to store it that way and into a plastic sleeve or in the original packaging, however you want. But I purchased this stamp storage system from the Stamp Market, and it comes with like these laminated sheets with tabs. And so I've just been using my label maker and labeling the name of the stamp set at the top, and then this sticks right to it. And I want to mention, I got that one kind of tight. I cut these down. They come a little bit longer, and I felt like it was extra space that I didn't need. They were probably, probably that long, because I even cut these down. So yeah, I don't know what my problem is. I just have to trim everything to make it like exact. But anyway, I got a little close on this one. There's some actual plastic sticking back out, so I will probably have to trim a little bit of the plastic off of this guy. But I just wanted to show you kind of the process of how I did that. So I printed out a little label. It's so nice though, just to like pull this on and off, not worry about the plastic backing anymore. And then again, I cut these little plastic sleeves down a little bit too. I cut the top off a tiny bit, and this one will fit better once I trim off that plastic from the bottom. Like it'll slide all the way in there. So it's really slick. And then I just decided to store by company. That's like kind of the first and foremost thing that I know to look for a stamp. I can definitely like think, oh, I want to use that stamp from that company. And so that just makes sense to me to sort by company. I also have affiliate links with some of these companies. And so it makes sense for me to be like, hey, what do I have from that company that I could share with you guys that if you purchase, then I get a little kickback. So I'll kind of flip through these really quick because this answers also the question of what are my favorite stamps. These right here, in addition to the monthly series stamp sets from Studio Calico, which I have stored separately because they're smaller, these are like my favorite stamps. So here we go, let's just kind of pop through them. The Stamp Market, I just showed you this life, love it. They have this gorgeous month-to-month scripty set that is just really beautiful, really fun way to add the date at the top of your pages. I do like the Stencil Alphabet. You guys have seen that probably pop up recently. I'll use the E, like, in reference for Etsy. I used to use it for EverEve when I worked there, but like when I know I have a day that I'm working office hours, like it's a really fun way to block off some time with a large E, so I do that one a lot. But also it would be fun to stamp your month across the top or on the, you know, you can title things really well with this set. Then I have this Hello Hexagon set. This is an older one, and I haven't used this as much, but I think I've used this as in the past, like on a more of a mission board concept that I used to do. I haven't been creating those lately, I just realized that. But I think that that's maybe what I had in mind when I bought the hexagons, so that's probably partly. But I love the stripes and the simple shapes. These guys are cute and fun to use too, like to add events into your planner. And then I have this detailed diamonds. I think I shared a daily page where I use this like completely to decorate the daily page, little open section. Again, just a fun, simple shape to repeat. And just like kind of when you feel that need to create something, it doesn't have to be anything elaborate. It's just using some different colors with diamonds and it turns out really cute. So I really like that one. Then Studio Calico is another favorite brand that I use a lot of. And this is a Stay Safe, Stay Home set. It is so cute. I have clearly used it a ton all throughout quarantine. You know, every week it was like, okay, stay safe, stay home. And these are like almost really fun journaling prompts if you're a journaler or you have a notebook and you just want to add some little headers or titles or details around your journaling. I feel like these were fun. Like it's like, oh, my daughter worked on puzzles. That's a great reminder of how we spent some time during quarantine. This is a collaboration, I believe, with the In a Creative Bubble. She's just such a fun artist. I really like her style. Another one that I picked up from there was this National Park set. And it's not so much that we visit the national parks, but I loved this circle. I knew that that was something that I could potentially use. I like to house a date or a certain event. Like in my planner, I love to use circles and I have circles in all different sizes. So whenever I see a fun circle shape, I tend to like snag it. I also liked the trees though and just kind of the great outdoors concept here. We do a little bit of camping and boating and so it's just kind of fun to mark that off in my planner or even in my memory keeping, which I have not done anymore. Go ahead and call me out. I haven't done for a long time, but I have in the past. Okay, I put little stickers on these because these are sets that are no longer available and I just kind of wanted to remind myself like, okay, yes, I love this set. Again, circles, cannot get enough. But maybe like, you know, don't use it a ton because it's not like something that you guys can track down. Same thing for this sleep set. It's just so cute. I liked the clouds. I thought that they were really fun. I remember doing some clouds around my week numbers at the top of my pages, but I love this one. Dear Naps, I'm sorry I hated you as a kid. Like, hello. I showed that to my daughter because I used to always make her take a nap and she hated it. Now she's in college and she loves to nap. So this is, again, another circle shape that I really love. It's just interesting. It has like a little detailing to it that's just unusual. So those are really fun. This is a great one too to add an event. Like you can put the time and the event information either way, like sideways or vertical. This Oliver number set is such a favorite of mine. You can see like every one of these is stained and loved. I use the AM and PM often in my teacher layout insert that you guys have seen me do. So this is a really just classic favorite. I wish that they would bring this back. If we all email Studio Calico, maybe they would, I don't know. But something like it would be really great too. I have another option that I've been using lately, the Studio L2E smaller little, just the number set. I think it's sitting on my desk, so maybe I'll go grab it for you guys. But it's really similar in font, but just smaller in size. And then I have these old like favorites. I really love this label here from Studio Calico old set, like probably 2014, I don't know, 2015. And then of course my dinner plate set. And so these are not actually available anymore, but I keep these around because I love them. Felicity Jane is another really, really, really great place to pick up stamps. And while I'm talking about all these stamps, I'm not trying to be snobby about like the brands I use, but I will say if you guys go to Michael's and buy like a dollar stamp or something super, super cheap, be prepared that it just, sometimes they're not cut deep enough. So when you go to stamp, like it doesn't create a crisp image, and it can be so frustrating because you have a picture in your mind of how you want it to turn out. If you don't start with a quality stamp, it's making your job even harder. It's already kind of hard to like get a really crisp image and to get everything all perfect. So if you have a quality stamp, it helps. If you start with a like cheap, you know, good deal, sometimes it's harder. And I'm not going to say that across the board. There may be some really great stamps that you can find on sale at Michael's. I have no idea. I have not tested all of them, but I know in the past when I have purchased a set, like thinking, oh, what a great deal, I've struggled with them. So I'm just going to say that. And I'm going to call out the Happy Planner, because you would think that those would be something that you could definitely count on and rely on. And I've had sets from them in the past that I've thrown away because I was so frustrated. So I'm just going to mention that, and you guys can, you know, let me know if you find something that does work really well and a good deal. But these, I'm not saying they're super expensive, but they're just not like necessarily steals, but they're worth like the pennies because you just get a better deal. So this Bold Alpha is an absolute favorite of mine. I love it. It's just like this E I used a ton for Evereve. I use it for Etsy. I love, like, if I make someone a handmade card or I send someone a gift in the mail, I usually stamp their initial with this one just like for fun, just to, you know, jazz up an envelope or something. So this is just a really, really good classic fun set, good size. You can definitely, at the top of my pages usually fit like a month if you wanted to type out May or something. It's cute. I've done December, like DEC. These are really cute. And this Plan On It set is another one that Felicity Jane designed. And these are great. Like, it includes all the dates, the 1 through 31. Of course, you have the days of the week and some other little details down in there too. I don't use some of these darker solid stamps as much as I probably should. Sometimes I worry about the bleed through, or more so like shadowing. Like any ink, the thicker the stamp, the more chance you have of it like shadowing through. So sometimes I shy away, and I need to remember to just pull this out and use it with some of my lighter colors. It would be fine. Scrapbook.com is another place. Like, obviously they gear towards scrapbookers and a lot of stamp card making, but you can definitely find some stamps in there. Like, these ones are actually their home brand, scrapbook.com brand. This is Months and Years. Such a good classic stamp if you need just a good monthly set. You can tell I have several because I do this a lot, so I like to have a little bit of variety, but this is a really, really good one. I have a smaller one in here, just the short abbreviated ones. It's called Just Months, and I really enjoy using that one just in tighter spaces. Like, if you're in a small little pocket planner, this is perfect. Just good little size. And then we have the Big Dates stamps. You know, it reminds me of the Studio Calico. They have like a mega date stamp, and it's like you don't have the hassle of like twisting and turning and trying to line everything up. You just get to use, kind of get that same look, but it's with just a simpler approach using the acrylic stamp sets. So the years go through 2025. You can stamp your own dates that way, and then all the months of the year over there. And then this, oops, I have one down in here. This is a Kelly Perky stamp set. Again, super old classic one that I've used often. I like using these little guys too. I've found creative ways. Like, this can be like a YouTube video day or something. These are good for on my hourly pages sometimes to block out a whole hour. I think I've used those before in some of the smaller pages. So again, just a really good classic set. And this is another font that I just like. This one is from Concord and Knight, sold through scrapbook.com, and a good classic font that I just really love. You can tell I kind of gravitate towards that clean look. Love it. Okay, I already showed you guys my Feed Your Craft section, so I'm going to scoot through those. Then Kelly Perky is now called like Paper Person. She's changed her branding, and she has some really great stamps. All of these are old, I believe, so like I don't think any of them are available per se anymore. This one's called Yes, but she always has some really clean, cool looking stamps. I like her aesthetic a lot. This one was from last Christmas called Spread Joy. Some really cool classic shapes. Love it. And another font similar to the one I just showed you. This one's called Roosevelt, a little bit smaller. And just again, that nice clean font. Really, really like those. Studio L2E is a company that, like, basically she, I feel like, was the first like planner stamping company out there. And I just like appreciate that about her, just like that she went out on that big limb and it proved, you know, some of us proved to her like, yes, we do, we like stamping in our planners. So this is a really old set, like Iconic Borders it's called, and then this is called a travel tag set. I mentioned earlier that I use a lot of her Just the Numbers set, and so I'm just always drawn towards like these. I think a lot of her sets, and I used to have a lot more, they were geared more towards the Erin Condren pages, like size wise like the width. And right now I'm not using planners that necessarily have that vertical, you know, column anymore. I used to use a lot of hers when I was planning in those original like week on two page vertical sheets. I don't plan on those as much anymore, so I feel like I haven't used hers as often, but still, just classic company, great stuff. Let me grab that numbers one so that I don't forget. So this is just the numbers, and I have this sitting on my desk. Like you can see, it's very similar to the olive number, but just a lot smaller. So a really good staple to have if you're ever, you know, dating your pages, really good thing to have around. Then I just have like, oh gosh, oh boy, do I even show you guys this? How embarrassing. I have a miscellaneous section, and there are just stamps that I have loved over the years, like from different sets. And so when you guys, if I ever use these and you ask me, oh, where's that one from? I'm like, oh, I have no idea. Sorry. But these are just cool, like fonts. They're just cool ways, like a to-do list here. I love some of these. These are just good classic ones that I felt like, okay, I don't need to keep every stamp set I've ever owned, but I'm gonna cut out the stamps that I love and stick them in here. Not brilliant. They aren't like, they're sliding around and it's kind of a hot mess, but for right now they're contained. These are some cute like social media icons that I have. This is a waffle craft. I feel like I ordered that either through Amazon or scrapbook.com. I can't remember. And then just older sets like from Studio Calico, and this is kind of like my icons. So I have any old icons or things that represent, you know, a car, an airplane, a circle, a star. Those are kind of all gathered there. This is more of like my shapes, like circles that I love. I love that brush stroke. I think that's Felicity Jane, but I don't know for sure. And just little details that I think, oh, I would like to add those to my pages. And then more of like how it used to be, like I would use a stamp like this to add an event into my page. I don't use those, like I said, as much anymore. So yeah, that's like where this classic Studio L2E, like she was so good at just that basic stuff. I loved it. I just kept these like around just in case I ever, this was like Scraptastic. And I absolutely loved that because you could put like a little icon stamp in there and like have the event information around it. So cute. But yeah, so there's that. I'm kind of embarrassed. Moving on. And then I have like one little stamp set back here, Creative Retreat, some numbers. You can tell I love numbers and all different sizes and a lot of this font. Like I really do like that font. So I just wanted to kind of walk you guys through this storage. I will link you down to like the setup for the storage in case it's something you want to check out. The system comes with like the colored cards and they're a little bit taller, so they're meant to stand out above. And then the white ones just fill in between. And you can set it up however you want, by brand. Some people do like, you know, alphabets, florals, however you, whatever stamps you have. But like I said, brand just made sense to me. So there's that. And then there's also like larger ones for this. And I haven't actually set that up quite as nicely. I need to find a container and all the things to get that going. But for now, I just store my stamps in these and I have those in my closet. This is a container that I bought from scrapbook.com. It's like a, you could put ink in here, like store ink, so it's almost like you could use it as a tower standing up. I'm not gonna do that right now, but I just have it so it like will sit down, and it stores my smaller stamps, primarily from Studio Calico. So I have some old ones, but this is where I store my monthly series. So I have like January-ish related stamps, February-ish like hearts and things, and then I just go like March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, and then November is here, but December is still in my on my desk, ready to use this month. So this is a really great container. There's like a lot of things you can do with it, but I just enjoy keeping these right here. They're kind of down below me, so they're tucked away a little bit. I don't need all of the months of the year out all the time, so I just bring out the ones that I feel like I'll be working with at the time. I'm just gonna show you really quickly. This is like the original sizes that come with the packaging. So you, oh wow, yeah, I cut it quite a bit. I decided to trim off the bottom parts of these, you know, so that I wasn't losing my tab at the top. But you can see like it's a good couple inches that I cut off each of those sizes and then just staggered them. I just found that if my stamp was 4x6, I just didn't need all that space. I don't know. It wasn't necessary, but I did it. So I'm committed now. Hope that gives you some answers to some of the questions. I do, like I said, get a lot of these, and I try to update my website to say like stamps that I use a lot of, or you know, inks that I use a lot of. And so like my favorites, but here's a really good video to show. Like these are literally my favorites that I've really pared down over the years. Like, these are my favorites. So thank you guys so much for joining. If you like this video and wanna see some more content from me in the future, please take a minute to subscribe. I'd appreciate it. Also, if you give me a thumbs up on this video, it helps kind of share the news that it's a video worth watching, and I appreciate that. All right, you guys, hope you're doing well, and until next time, take care.